This is Duke University.
One wonders whether the United States is a welcome broker or an unwelcome broker, and if there needs to be a third broker in all this.
I do believe that the Palestinians and Israelis should not be left alone. It will not get us anywhere if we say that peace should be the direct negotiations between Israelis and the Palestinians, because ultimately any treaty would reflect the balance of power at the time it is concluded, and there's a big gap between the Palestinians and the Israelis, and the international community should basically affirm its position. There are UN resolutions that should be respected, that they should be implemented, and the European Union made steady positive steps in that direction. The United States is definitely welcomed as a major player, but we need also the United States to not to leave the matter to the Israelis and the Palestinians, to come up with a position that is in line with international law, that is in line with UN resolutions, and we need to see a little bit more seriousness about establishing that Palestinian state, or basically coming, you know, that it cannot basically allowing this to drag everyone endlessly. It has been long enough up till now.
How much now is the tension between Israel and Iran affecting the ability for the peace process to move forward?
I think when we talk about the relationship between the United States and Iran, when we talk about negotiations to conclude a deal about the Iranian nuclear program, this should not influence the idea of ending the occupation, coming up with a decent resolution for this. But I think also at the same time that the Israeli Prime Minister uses the Iranian ticket to avoid addressing the real issue at home, which is basically ending the occupation and facing his own community rather than creating, or depending on politics of fear. This cannot basically be sustained forever. And the United States, the White House, but also the Congress itself should send a clear message rather than supporting Israel, in the absolute sense. They should also tell Netanyahu enough is enough. The European parliaments, many of them, as we have seen during last year, many of them basically voted, albeit symbolically, in recognition, in favor of recognizing a Palestinian state. Sweden went even ahead with recognizing the state of Palestine. The Congress is way too far behind the European position.
So the U.S. Congress, the Republican-led
Congress? Basically, the Republican-led Congress is way behind its European counterpart. And the issue is, it's not about Iran. It should be basically, the issue is the Israeli occupation. We need to end this.